gosh, I literally recorded this long thing and then it wasn't recording. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Oh my gosh, I'm just gonna tell this whole story again. The last video that I recorded, I was getting ready for my first bodybuilding competition, which was awesome. Maybe I'll put clips together to kind of share the experience because I never obviously got to it. But life update is now I am exactly 1 year later baby building, and I am 35 weeks. No, wait, I'm sorry. I'm 39 weeks and 4 days today. So I'm recording this because I'm attempting to do a birthing vlog or birth story for myself, for my baby when he gets older, and just for the memories. So about 35 weeks, we thought he flipped. He didn't flip. He's not breached, but he was like not head down. They gave us two options and they were like, you can do, I think it's called a DNC, where they flip them for you. Didn't seem like the right thing for me. I was like, nah, the risks, nah, I'm good. He's fine. I don't mind having a C-section if I really have to. And then they were like, there's always a chance he'll flip back. So I'm like, don't see a point. So I was supposed to have a doctor's appointment last week. I did not have it because I didn't really want the pelvic check and all that stuff just yet. I didn't want to get discouraged if they told me he didn't flip, because I know he flipped, but then I took a long nap and then he flipped back. So I'm convinced when he's ready, he will do what he needs to do. That being said, I have my last appointment. I say last. This Friday, which I will be right 1 day shy of 40 weeks. Tomorrow's 10-10. I'm hoping that the baby comes tomorrow because that would be a cute birthday. I have a super busy day today and I'm at an appointment that was really hard to get. I have to do one last Costco run, and Ethan, the older brother, has a haircut at 5:30. After that, like, everything's done. We have postpartum station upstairs, downstairs. Hospital bags have been packed for a while just because they told me that I was having a lot of contractions at 36 weeks, and just to be ready because they thought he was gonna come. I had listened to influencers, which I regret. And I was drinking that red leaf tea at the beginning of my third trimester, and my doctor was like, don't do that. Like, you don't need to be inducing labor at the beginning of your third trimester. Baby's still growing his lungs and stuff up to 37 weeks. We don't need it. And it was making me have contractions, and he's like, stop it. So I did stop it. But luckily, like, the contractions kind of stopped because I was having like some crazy ones. Or they slowed down. They weren't as wild. And, but we also have like the postpartum meals and breakfast and stuff like prepped. And there's one more meal I would like to prep tonight if I have time. If not, like, it's not that big of a deal. And what else? Let me see. And, yeah, today's the 9th. Tomorrow would be a great day for the baby to come. He can come like late tonight and just make it past midnight for 10-10, or he can start coming after I drop Ethan off at school, or come when I pick up Ethan from school but get here before midnight to make 10-10. These are just like wild things that, like, it would just be cute. If not, like, he can come whenever, but 10-10 we just thought was cute. And then it gives me like 6 days to where me and his birthday might be close but not the same day, so we can still have little separate celebrations. But I also wanted to record this just in case I go into labor today, because I woke up fine with lots of energy this morning, but then after I dropped off Ethan, I came home and I heard water, and somehow the toilet overflowed. Luckily with clean water, but still, like, it was like all over the bathroom. It kind of started leaking to the downstairs bathroom, like, not like crazy, but I don't know if it was the condensation. I don't know, because it doesn't, it can't tell where it really started leaking from or nothing, like, but I used all the towels, to clean up the bathroom. Luckily, it was clean toilet water again. But to carry all those wet, heavy towels downstairs to the washer, that kind of made my pelvic area start to feel way heavy. And I've been wobbling ever since. I've been running my errands today. Like, everything's taking, like, breath out of me. Yeah. And, so that's why I'm like, okay, if he comes today, let me record this just in case. Or if he comes tonight, whatever. Because I've been meaning to record this and I just, like, keep putting it off. But I thought that was funny. I was like, there's a water break, a water leak, and water everywhere, but it's not my water. So, I guess the next part of this, I will find out if I'm having a C-section or if I'm having a natural birth. I have a safe word for my natural birth that if I cannot do it, I have a safe word for dad and my friend to know. But I am going to push for it. I really wanted to get that golden hour. This pregnancy has been a lot more stressful mentally and emotionally than when my first son. Like, I didn't work with I didn't really work that pregnancy. Like, maybe the first trimester. I was always happy. I was active. I did stay active. But this one, it was just, like, hormones were just way worse. So I wanted that golden hour and all that extra stuff. And naturally, for any extra hormones and feelings to help with postpartum and to help, like, the baby feel, like, I don't know, happy when he comes out. But we will see. If it's a C-section, it's a C-section. As long as me and him are safe, I'm okay with it. But yeah, I think that's all I was going to say. next thing you guys will see will be the baby. It is 6:22, I think. We're about to be 6:30. Yeah, 6:22 actually, and I had contractions all night. What, Brucey? They're 30 minutes apart, actually. 20 to 30 minutes apart, but they're getting stronger. I have a doctor's appointment at 9 a.m., but we're going to drop off Ethan, and then I'm going to call and ask, do I come in for my appointment, or do I just go next door to the hospital? If I keep moving and keep my mind busy, it doesn't hurt as bad. But I was trying to sleep through them, and then I would be able to go to sleep, and then I would just be like, whoa, woken up. The only reason, like, I'm, like, doing my hair at all right now is to keep me distracted. I'm gonna make some breakfast. What's the dogs? Let the dogs out. Do everything like I do usually. I'm just not gonna drive because I don't want to be in an accident. What else was I gonna say? Read my Bible, did my prayers, and Ethan's gonna wake up here in a little bit to start getting ready for school. And that's pretty much the update. We'll see what happens. I think the baby flipped. I think he's head down. I'm pretty sure there's feet in my ribs and that he's head down. So, God willing.
Anything else? Anything for breakfast? Any other drinks?
No, that's gonna be it.
All right. So, update. This is so funny. This is not how I expected my birthing vlog or story to go at all. But, baby did not flip. He's not going to flip. It's something to do with my uterus. It's not letting him, which actually happened with my son. I'm not dilated. And I've been in false labor. I'm telling you that red leaf tea, guys. So we have a scheduled C-section for Monday at 6 a.m. And I've been I'm not on bed rest, but I've just been told to relax. She said I could take Tylenol for my false labor,
are my false contractions. I'm like, they feel real. But she's like, warm bubble baths. She's like, don't be walking. Don't be going doing crazy stairs or doing anything to induce labor. She's like, just relax. Enjoy the weekend. And come in Monday morning. So the baby will be the 14th and my birthday is the 16th. And we're just gonna relax this weekend. That's the update. It's crazy. Literally, what a morning. So dad went to go work half a day since we don't need the whole day off for the baby. But yeah. Next time you see me, you'll see a baby. I'm here watching Ethan's probably last football practice that I'll be able to come and hang out at because the baby's coming. It's so funny because the joke was really on me, like really tracking my contractions, and they were getting stronger. Some weren't that bad, some were like super bad, and I was like, I'm for sure going into labor. So anyways, I just, as I'm sitting here, I'm just like, wanted to share a fun fact before I forget to share it later. I don't even remember if I shared it earlier because I have a pregnancy brain that's like the worst. But the hospital, or the doctor that I picked because the hospital was like down the street from my house. And since it's new, they only had 6 delivery rooms. And because I'm a scheduled C-section, I'm kind of a last minute schedule. I wasn't able to get into it. So I'm going to be at the downtown location, which is not near my house, which is a bummer because I wanted to be closer to home if I forgot something. Dad's going to have to go back and forth to feed the dogs, take care of Ethan and everything. And that's a lot more driving. But fun fact, Dad was born at this hospital downtown. So I was like, that's kind of cute. You guys are born in the same hospital. I don't think I was born downtown. I just got another birth certificate because I couldn't find my old one. But I don't remember where I was born. I was born in Baptist, I think. But I don't remember what location. But I just thought that was cute. So I was like, I'm going to put that in the birth vlog or story or whatever so that baby can know you were born in the same hospital as your dad. All right. Gonna go back there in 30 minutes.
Sit down, yes, and we can hold him, like give him to you.
Yes.
To hold.
Yeah.
You want to do that?
Yes.
Okay. I can help you. Or my sister can help her. Either so one. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to be home.
What am I doing?
Give him. Let's get this swaddle and make it.
I saw all of them do it. I don't know how to do it still. I know they do that.
Okay. It'll be fine.
I'm gonna get him.
It doesn't have to be perfect. They were cozy.
Uh oh.
It's okay.
You did something.
It's okay. Lay him down. Lay him down and hold his head. Ready? Gotta hold his head. You've held babies before, Bubba. Come on, this is your brother.
It's your brother.
There, he's got the middle name you wanted.
Actually?
Yes.
There, you come in and do that?
No, but I'm filling the paperwork out. Well, he's here. Stephanie's calling. You're strong, dude. Oh, you're so strong, so handsome.
Yeah, he's sweet.
He's sweet. He's ready. Daddy walk.